Hi, I'm Tiffany, and this is Towering TBR. I am so excited to share my TBR for the Magical Readathon. I have participated in the Magical Readathon for 5 years, every single year that it's been done. It started out as a Harry Potter Readathon, and then it has transitioned into G's own magical world. And it's autumn equinox, which means we're gonna do the second half of the readathon. The first part was in April. I'm going to link G and all of her documents down below, because if you don't know what I'm talking about, there's a lot. This is a very fun but very involved readathon. So, in April, I went for the career of Archmage. I'll put up my character sheet. I'm playing as a dwarf, and I'm in the House of the Arcane. In the spring semester, I was required to follow 6 prompts, and in this readathon, I am going to have 8 prompts. So similar to how it was back when it was the Newts, for each subject, there are 3 levels of grades. So if you only need to be ordinary, then you only have to follow 1 prompt, where if it requires a qualified, you have to read 2 books, and if it's a distinguished grade that you need, you have to read 3 prompts. So for my Archmage career, I have 8 prompts. The first is Alchemy Ordinary Level. Read a book on someone's worst list that you might actually like. So this actually took me the longest time to find because I believe the booktubers that I watch, and if they say it's bad, I don't tend to want to pick it up. So I slightly altered it to include a DNF. So Mercedes over at Mercy's Bookish Musings DNF'd the book Queenie. And I think this is a book I'm gonna like. It's about a mixed race woman living in London. And I think her life is just kinda, I don't know, falling apart. And I think it's somewhat of like a women's fiction book, but I think it has some more hard hitting topics. So I'm really looking forward to reading this. And if I agree with Mercedes, I may DNF it too, but this was the best option that I could find. The second one for the alchemy is to read an orange book, and Queenie would have been perfect for that, but my other option was The Chalk Man by C.J. Tudor. I think this is a mystery or thriller focusing on a group of kids who create like this little chalk figurine when they were kids, and like 20 years later it's showing up at crime scenes. And so they're maybe thinking that they know the killer. I don't really know a whole lot about it, and I'm fine with that. I would love to be surprised and have lots of twists. So I'm reading this for Read an Orange Book. And lastly, because I do need to get a distinguished in alchemy, I have picked Kindred for the prompt One Word Title. So I have been wanting to read Kindred for quite a while. It's about a woman in the 1970s who's black, and all of a sudden she starts time traveling to the past during slavery times, which is really dangerous for her, and she has no control over this time travel. I've heard it's really intense, and I think I'm ready for it. So this is going to be my book for the prompt One Word Title. Then for the class Artificery, I only need to get an ordinary, so that's only 1 prompt. And the prompt is a book featuring artificial intelligence. So it just so happened that I had decided to pick up Heaven's River by Dennis E. Taylor, the 4th book in the Bob universe. And he is an AI. His consciousness is uploaded to a software, and he can clone himself and ships to help the humans as they spread out throughout space. It's the fourth book in a series, though, so I don't really feel like I can tell you much, but I'm really excited about it, and I expect it to be fast-paced and funny. For Inscription, I need Qualified, so that's two prompts. The first is a childhood favorite, and for that, I went with A Wrinkle in Time by Madeleine L'Engle. This was probably the first sci-fi book I ever picked up as a kid, and I remember thinking just how out of my comfort zone it was, but how much I loved it. I haven't seen the movie or anything, and it's been since childhood that I read it, so I've forgotten quite a bit, and so yeah, I'll get to rediscover a childhood favorite. For the qualified prompt for Inscription, it is read a graphic novel, comic, or manga. And if you watch my channel for any length of time, you know I read quite a few of those, and I could have picked pretty much anything. But I decided to pick The Property by Ruutu Modan, in part because it's translated. It's Women in Translation Month in August, and during the second week, there is another readathon that I intend to participate in, sort of a little bit. And this is translated from the Hebrew, and it's about a woman who goes back to Warsaw after World War II to try and reclaim some property that was stolen from her family during the war. It looks really good, and I'm really excited, and I will be picking this up during the second week of August. I'm also adding Tears of Amber to my August TBR that I intend to read during the second week of August for Women in Translation Readathon. I don't want to push my luck doing too much, so I'm just going to be reading these two for Women in Translation. For Spells and Incantations, I also need a qualified, which is two prompts. So I had a color wheel. I will put it up on the screen, but you will see that the result was light blue. And I have picked two books actually for that because I can't decide. I'm very much a mood reader, so setting a really strict TBR can be challenging. But the first book that I'm considering for light blue is The Invisible Kingdom, Something About Chronic Illness by Megan O'Rourke. This is a nonfiction book talking about invisible disabilities and chronic illness, and since I'm a spoonie, that appeals to me. And if you don't know what a spoonie is, it is a person with limited energy. The other option that I've thought of is The Lathe of Heaven by Ursula K. Le Guin. I haven't read any of her stuff, and I've heard really good reviews of this book. It's also really short, which is great when you're doing a readathon because it helps you feel more accomplished when you finish a book. All I know is that there's a man and he somehow can shape reality with his dreams. That's all I know, and I'm really excited for it. And it's got lots of shades of blue, so definitely light blue in the middle. Is pick a book from somebody else's TBR. And I picked Olive from a book Olive's TBR. She read last year Mary Jane by Jessica Anya Blau. And this is a book that is set in the 1970s and it has like a coming of age story of this teen who somehow meets a rock star who's trying to become sober. I've heard a lot of people compare it to Daisy Jones and the Six, and so it sounds like a really good summer read. All right, that was all of my prompts. I hope that if you're participating, let me know what you're reading and what, let me know what career you're going for. And if you aren't and you've just now heard about this, definitely join. It's not too late. It's lots of fun. Takes place the whole month of August, so you've got lots of time, and you can pick less challenging careers that don't have as many prompts as what I'm doing. So, or if you, if you can read lots more, you can pick more challenging ones. And I hope you will join us for the readathon. And I'm so excited as the BookTuber to be participating in this once again. Thank you so much for joining. Bye.